stomach in a bit of a weird position because I had an operation recently, but I'm here and so that's good. I worry the speech, but I don't think I'm in a such a good state to read it at the moment. So I hope you don't mind, but my mum will read it for me.
I've always had an interest in music. At around the age of 10, I started bashing around with music notation software with no idea what I was doing. After some time, I considered taking up music theory. On Andrew's advice, I decided that the most knowledgeable expert on the subject was none other than Mrs. Patterson. After a few lessons, I would go home and write outrageously difficult and pointless compositions. And Mrs. Patterson always answered with the expression, putting the cart before the horse. 3 years later, and approximately 3 music theory books on, I decided that for my major project, I'd write a piece of music that I hoped would counter the cart before the horse theory. The result was a rather long piano piece based in the key of B minor, with 2 contrasting themes that go throughout. I conceived the idea in Tweedhead's family holiday spot while watching seagulls drifting around the bay. A few weeks later, I took it to Mrs. Patterson, and with a childish mindset that everything would be perfect already. But alas, together with human technical skill and Mrs. Patterson's strong music base, I accepted that conventional harmony had other ideas. We settled on a series of drafts to tighten up the work and fix the impossible jumps in the middle section. After many tries and many technical mishaps, we settled on the work you see and hear today. One of the moments and antidotes to the tough and reckless computer problems occurred when a primary student came in for their music lesson while Mrs. Patterson was practicing my piece. The student proclaimed that the piece sounded like a bird, and that sentence really lifted our hearts and made us realise that I'd achieved a manipulation of human feeling in the music, and so I kept its original title and notion of flight. Soon I was close to finishing, and I resorted to making a full project, cover and all. I drew a picture of Julia and added to the next. I hope you'll take the time to look at the finished product. In conclusion, I learned patience, to be grateful for the many people, many hours people invest in me, to listen to the wisest of comments, and learn to hate computers for being machines, even if they're not Windows. Lastly, I would like to thank all the people who helped me make this project possible and a wonderful journey. I will be brief. Firstly, I have an unpayable debt to Mrs. Patterson for the hundreds of hours of constructive criticism, wise advice, and pure sheer knowledge she poured into me over the 6 months of this very enjoyable journey. Thanks also to Julia for helping me with the design and drawing, to my parents for enduring many hours of playback of my piece and many hours of music lessons through which I have now achieved this result. Thank you again, Mrs. Patterson, for the performance, and thank you for listening.